This is St. Andrew's Castle. That's quite a nice day. It's the very picturesque ruins of the castle. And this is the castle as it once looked. Home to the most senior bishops and archbishops in Scotland, the castle was razed and rebuilt several times over. Dry moat. And let's just take a stroll into the castle. So the castle was through the tower at the centre of the south front. You can hear oyster catchers and gulls passing over. Starts excavated to the curtain. Back of the outer wall. Okay, stick the wall. Oh, my knapsack. It's caught there. This is the way to the mine. And the counter mine. Yeah, that pool there, I mean, it's so, yeah, it looks so straight and, well, almost rectangular. Yeah, I wonder if it's artificial. Some an account of some of the bloody thing, well, I say bloody not in the sense of a profanity, the bloody things done in the name of religion in the 16th century. Now the mine and the counter mine. I'm heading down here. Now, members of the public are admitted to these subterranean passages at their own risk. Oh well. Must bear that in mind. It's a wee bit cramped, to say the least. And certainly not for claustrophobic people. And I've got a rucksack on my back. So I think I'll turn back and go back into the open air. Right, we'll have to come back here sometime without a rucksack. Used to be the stair leading up to the chapel. And here's where the castle hall used to be. I'm looking towards the ruins of the cathedral. Oh yeah. Yeah, I'm looking from the castle towards the North Sea and the headland, which indicates that Charts of Fire was not filmed at Broadstairs in Kent. Well, you can see, yeah, it looks like eiders down there on the rocks, yep. Well-known species of sea duck. So, this is St Andrew's Castle, yep. A really fascinating place, and well worth checking out.